All right, so now being 5:45, I'll call the April 24th meeting of the Plimpton Board of Selectmen to order. This meeting is being cablecast, but the minutes are always the official record of the meeting. So we've got Finance Committee with us tonight. We're going to be talking about, and the police chief, and Rob Frelott from Highway, to talk about the proposed budget, the annual town meeting, and the special town meeting warrant articles, and expecting votes of recommendation or not recommending, depending on the case. So do you want to take it away, Liz?
Sure. So some of them are just the regular customary ones. So Article 2, do you want to vote that one? Do you want to take some in a group? It's probably easier than doing individual votes.
And so Finance Committee, you guys have already voted on these?
They don't vote number 2.
Okay.
Typically. And then number 3 is the standard wage and personnel chart.
Just the annual?
Do you want to vote 2 and 3 together first?
Well, have they voted either one?
They don't vote these two.
They don't vote these, okay.
All right, so I'll make a motion that the selectmen recommend Articles 2 and 3 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And then 4 is the budget, so we said we'd come back to that.
Yep, we'll come back to the budget.
5 is the standard one to pay for our financial audits. Did FinCom already vote number 5?
Yeah, we voted.
Favorable?
Yeah, favorable.
Okay. Do you want to take a vote on 5?
Sure.
Sure.
Let me see.
All right, I'll make a motion that the selectmen recommend Article 5 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Yeah, we have it up here.
Okay. Article 6 is for the new lease agreement for the police vehicle. FinCom, did you vote 6?
Yes, we voted in favor unanimously.
Okay.
All right, and this is just the article that the chief puts on there every year?
Correct.
Okay. I did miss your really good description of how you're able to sell them out to. I'll have to watch that on your presentation to Finance Committee, because I think you talked about how you were able to make money on the old vehicles as well.
Yes, yeah, so that was a good little thing that we kind of did, especially where a lot of long streets here, and we have a lot of officers that utilize the cruisers. So basically utilizing them for all utilities in town, or whatever, kind of worked out well for us to sub those cruisers out and bring some money back into the department. So it worked out well.
Great, yeah. Very good. All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 6 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, 7, I think FinCom had been holding, and this is for the school resource officer. Did you take a vote yet?
We have not voted on that yet.
Okay. Do you want to take your vote first, or do you have any questions for the chief?
I don't think I have any questions. Do you have any questions, anybody, for that resource officer for the Dennett?
So.
No.
No?
Mm-hmm. Someone want to make a motion?
I'll make a motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. It's unanimous.
Chief, I think I've got a question on that. Just basically looking for a little bit more information. So is this going to be like a full-time position? Will the individual be armed?
Yes, so I've always thought of the Dennett, that's our biggest vulnerability in town, and I never anticipated the ability to have an officer, full uniformed officer down there, but yes, it would be full uniform position, full carry. It's essentially just an extension of us here, but just down at the Dennett. So I've had extensive conversations with a lot of like members and families in town, as well as Peter Venuto and members of the school district, and I have such a big push, and there's a lot of push nationwide too. And unfortunately, it's sad to say, but there's a lot of integration into elementary schools now, and very close in proximity to local municipalities are doing a very similar thing. So when this was put on my plate, and we've been having some conversations about this over the last month, 2 months or so, when I saw the light in the tunnel that this could be afforded to us, I was very excited for it. And you know, talking to Peter, talking to, you know, Dana Smith is down at the school on Tuesdays now, and and integrating more officers down there for a full-time position, what type of programming can we, you know, account for down there? We, you know, there's RAD Kids, there's Dare America, there's a lot of different outlets and programs we can do other than just what we've done historically. There's a lot of new data out there, there's a lot of new programs that we can do, so I'm excited for it. I really truly am. It's been, it's exciting to see, and in a way that it's not exciting to have that, but it's exciting that we're going to have that available to the Denet. I know Peter Vino has been very excited to hear that this is going to be something that, you know, could be afforded to them.
Go ahead, Marilyn, you got a question?
I think my particular opinion on this is that we already have a police officer taking care of the middle school, so we certainly, you know, need to take care of the elementary school as well.
Right.
What are you going to do in the summer when the school is closed?
Yeah, so we've got a lot of, like, standard like policies from surrounding departments. So what a lot of departments do is they'll integrate back into like a police role, like a patrolman's role, depending on where they rank and they are in the structure of the department. So let's say vacation time, school vacation times, or like the summer months, they'll integrate back into a patrol position. So they'll come right back in, start working patrol shifts, which will, you know, help, you know, again, benefit patrol things. We're still working on, obviously, we're in the middle of grants and traffic enforcement grants and things like that, where we could always utilize another officer. We have still continuous complaints on traffic. So there's other ways that we can utilize this officer outside of the Denet Elementary when school's not in session. So it really is double-edged. So it's huge for us, absolutely huge.
I'm okay.
So have you heard any negative opinions about this?
I think you're always going to hear that, like, the perception of a police officer in school and, like, negative connotation around that. And again, it's not, I don't take it as like, this is exciting, we get to have a police officer in school. It's sad that we have a police officer in school. I never grew up with a police officer in school. I was one of the first DARE students to go through DARE program back in 1992, I think is when it came into my town. So, and again, it wasn't geared towards what it is now in learning about different traits of people. It was more in regards to like drug abuse, alcohol abuse, but there's so many more facets to like teaching kids and having that interaction at a young age. So you get both sides of it, but I think the push for this town, if what I hear is, we want it, we love it, what can we do to get somebody down there? That just was what I hear, you know, but I think you're always going to get some people. You might get teachers too that are like, I don't want a police officer down there, and I think you're going to get that anywhere. But I think what we do really well, and I'm really putting that on my staff over there, is community engagement. We're so good at it. We really truly care. So us going down there isn't a militant type of position. It's there to have that interaction, that positive reinforcement that we're here and a member of your community. We are you guys here. So we're like that first line of communication with the police department. So we have those, we create that bridge right there at a young age with a lot of the residents here in town. So I love that opportunity.
Yeah, I appreciate that opportunity. I actually really appreciate the potential with the right person in that position of a teaching opportunity, particularly for the students. So I'm not totally thrilled with the whole idea or that it's necessary, but I get what the potential is there, and I hope we really can take advantage of it.
Right. Yep.
Did this come, Matt, as a citizen's petition, or did you put it forth on your own?
So no, I had parents and that came forth that were asking about, like, could this ever be, you know, and then other people in town started talking about it, and then it eventually came into my office.
Okay. Okay.
More on the regular. So, but yeah, parents were really pushing, and then Peter was having conversations with them, and we have the monthly school safety meetings down at the Denet,
yeah.
And we have these conversations about how do we, you know, safeguard the school, and you know how we create all these action plans and for potential active shooter situations, and what do? We protect the class, we bring in more officers.
Sure.
And
sure.
So these conversations have been going on,
yeah.
I think, geez, since I stepped into this role. So this has been an ongoing thing, so, and here we are now, so.
It's sad, but it's today's world.
Right.
Yeah.
And to Mark's question, to go back on that, I mean, this might not just be one officer, this might be getting a couple officer trained so that we can augment. So let's just say Officer Smith needs to take a sabbatical or a leave or whatever it might be. Now we have another person that can step right in, so that role is always fulfilled. And depending on you know, how things, you know, fall out, so, or staffing situations. We'll always be able to have backfill and always have a person that can fulfill that role, so.
So, Chief, you would see it not really as an assigned role for one person, but you could have a multiple people that are, like, working through this position on a regular basis?
The hard part is like, the officer that we have down there right now currently is a part-time officer, and with just with the, like, bridge standard and police reform, we're only gonna see him for another year. So really, getting somebody trained and acclimated now, it's the most paramount time to do it, because there's a lot of onboarding and understanding, there's programs and things that they have to be brought up to speed with, and state law and everything, so. So it's gonna be a little bit of a learning curve and bringing somebody in, but then also, too, down the road, you might have a full-time a school resource officer, but doesn't mean that they're the only person that can be trained as a school resource officer. So that if some reason we had attrition or somebody moved on, different department or whatever, we have somebody that can slide right back into that role, so there's never gonna be a lag time. I always wanna make sure that we're safeguarding that school.
Okay. And security is first and foremost, and everything else is just kind of fluff, and is that really why we're doing this, is more for security of the building? And then all the, you know, building relationships with the kids and all the great positive programs, that's really just kind of like a bonus?
I don't know where I put that, to be honest with you. I don't know where I put that on the level. I think it's pretty close to the same, and it's, unfortunately, you look around the country and you see, when we started off at Sandy Hook and, you know, Uvalde and all these different schools, and it's so sad to see. And you never want to say it's not going to be our town. It's not going to be our town. You don't want to be so aloof to say that can't happen here. So, like, yes, security is at the foremost. But you also, again, the whole militant end of it, and the whole, like, you want to have a positive experience with these kids when they come in, and having the right attitude and the right communication, the High Five Fridays and the events and the things that we do down there, that it's not a scary police officer. It's someone that's there that cares, and we're doing all these programs and these outlets to engage with you and community relations and things like that. So it's not like it's a huge disparity. It's not too far off from each other, quite honestly.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Do you have any more questions?
No, I'm fine.
Okay, all right. I'll make a motion that if you're both okay with it, that the Board of Selectmen support Article 7 as submitted in the warrant. All right, do we have a second?
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you very much, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Spending time to talk to us about it.
Much appreciated.
Good presentation, Chief. That's,
thank you, sir.
Quite convincing.
Do you want to take 8 and 9 together?
Yeah,
it's
beautiful.
The normal Chapter 90 and then the $200,000 for road construction.
Okay.
Did FinCom, did you vote favorably on 9?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm.
All right. And Rob, you've got a plan for these roads? You've got or roads in mind already?
Yeah,
I'm sure there's no shortage of roads that need to be addressed.
No, there's not.
All right, so I'll make a motion that we recommend Articles 8 and 9 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
10 is for the Ventrac type machine for highway. Rob was here to discuss, and I think FinCom had put a hold on that one.
All right. Rob, did you want to give a little presentation about this machine and its capabilities?
Sure. Our role with the highway department's kind of grown a little bit. We now have to maintain parks, and it comes with has multiple attachments. I don't know if you saw any of the, have you guys seen any of the?
No.
Okay.
I looked it up.
You looked it up?
Mm-hmm.
Here is the price quotes that I have on it. If you want to scroll through, you can. It has a flail mower that goes in the front of it, which would be good in like the parks, like the walking paths, because the current brush hog we have now, flail mower, is far too big to go out there. It'll allow us to snow blow the sidewalks in the wintertime, which we don't currently do. We currently use a pickup truck and just drive up on the sidewalk and plow it off, and then we have to take two other trucks to plow it across the road, which is kind of dangerous and time-consuming and costly to the town. That you can put one person in there during the day, and they can just go about it on their normal daily route in the wintertime. Comes with a sidewalk room. We don't own a sidewalk sweeper. We borrow Halifax's when we're so fortunate to. So we'll be able to sweep sidewalks too, as well as snow blow them. Comes with a 95-inch field mower, which is good for the athletic fields of the school and Harry Park. The machine we have now that's attached to it, the mower deck itself is from, I think, 1997. You might, whatever year the field was built, that was when that mower deck was bought. And the machine we're running it off of now is a 2007 with like 3,500 hours on it. So it's starting to get tired. So this will help fill in with that. With the extra staffing that we have now, the four people, you can do a lot more, and it'd be nice to be able to utilize everyone in the department. Well, not that we don't already utilize them, but it would be nice to be able to do other things that other towns do that we currently can't, and this machine would allow us to do that. There's a fertilizer spreader for the back of it too, which we don't own one. We borrow one from Rick Burnett, which is very nice of him to let us use it, but this is also tired. And the
small
last time
towns.
We used it, we had to do some repairs to it before we could even use it. So it'd cover a lot of bases for the town of stuff that we either borrow or don't have in general.
I will say the town properties, you came before us, and...
Sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off. That was the other thing. There was a ballpark renovator and stuff to do, like the infields and the baseball
right.
fields. That's all done by volunteerism right now, and the highway department could assume that role and make it part of a routine maintenance to help keep our fields looking better. Yeah.
The town properties committee was supportive of what Rob is coming forth with.
The thing about that machine.
And I believe for several years, Halifax's machine was down, so we
yeah.
weren't able to borrow it to do
yeah.
the sidewalks. And,
and
obviously, they're going to get priority
yeah,
over
it
us.
It happens quite often. It's like every other year we get to use it, if we're lucky. The original machine that they had was a trackless. That was like a $100,000 machine that they bought way back in the early 90s. That machine just finally wore out. They have it on the front of a whacker now, and that machine's... They use it. It's got hours, so it's not dependable to borrow.
Rob, just a question for you quickly
sure.
on this. So was this the only quote that you guys got for?
It's on the state bid. There's only
yeah.
one price across the board
it's
for us.
It's the
yep.
only one, okay.
Yeah, I do actually have another quote from, I think, Northrop Equipment.
Yep.
Same price.
Yeah, okay. So it looks like the pricing here is $62,974. Is that without some of the attachments?
Yes, possibly. I think if you keep flipping through the pages, that I might have handed you the wrong one. I have a ton of stuff here.
Yeah. Well, that, it looks like then it starts going through the accessory.
Yes,
on the
and I
next
think if you
couple.
Follow in on that, there's another
yep.
paper with the prices of other attachments, because I had gotten a price on some other attachments separate. I believe that was the ball field.
Yep.
Off ones.
Oh, yeah, okay, and that comes down to the top. So you're trying to get all of the attachments with it that you can.
It would be nice to get it all in one shot, and then you don't have to keep revisiting this, and if
right.
you guys feel we should, I'm okay with that.
Have you had any experience with this particular machine?
No, not with this particular machine. I think it's Carver or Middleborough, one of them towns was getting them. There's a few other towns around with them that have them, and they tend to like them.
Yeah.
It's not as big as a trackless, which is a much nicer machine, but
yep.
you don't need that big of a machine. That's like half the size of it. And
right.
It would work pretty well for our needs in town.
Yeah, the only thing I was really kind of surprised on with a piece of equipment of this nature, it just seemed like a very short warranty on it.
Yeah.
That's kind of standard across
You've usually seen five, sometimes
it's only
six,
two
just
years.
Depending.
Yeah.
I don't know with that specific manufacturer, but that just seemed a little surprising.
Yeah.
Because of how, you know, how much abuse that they take.
Yeah.
Does any kind of a maintenance plan come with it or no?
We do all maintenance in-house. On all of our equipment, we do all the maintenance,
yep.
unless it's something, you know, we're not really... outfitted to handle.
Right.
But 99% of our things are done in house.
Yep. Got it.
Where's the machine from, Rob? Where's it made?
Who makes it?
Yeah.
Ventrac.
Are they local?
They're in Ohio.
They've been around for a long time. They actually share the same attachment hookup, I guess you could say, as a Jacobson. So there are other machines that could go to this attachment if you really wanted to, but I wouldn't want to go to a Jacobson. They're great municipal maintenance things. They use a lot of like golf courses and stuff like that because they're so versatile for what they do.
Yeah, they're owned by Toro is the parent company that bought them, I think, 2 years ago.
Yeah. Oh, you did some research on it then?
I did. It's a start reading through it.
Pretty neat machine for what it does.
No, I was actually not having known this brand. I was pleasantly surprised by some of the reviews on it. It does seem to be...
It is a pretty good machine.
Strong and pretty versatile. Usually a lot... My primary concern with anything, any type of equipment, when you buy something that's a multi-purpose machine with 8 million different attachments is that it never does anything well. And everything breaks. That doesn't seem to be what the reviews were saying.
One of those gimmicky machines. It's not like a... It's a well-built machine. It articulates and stuff. If you look at it, it's like a little tractor.
Right.
It's not like a homeowner-grade machine. It's pretty nice.
I think we're spending an awful lot of money this year. And I think this might be a very nice thing to have, but I don't think that this is the year to do it. That's my opinion. I don't know. Do we want to have any further discussion on this?
Yeah, I mean, I do agree with Marilyn as far as just the timing of it. And I appreciate Rob's commentary on it, and I do think it's something that seems like it would be nice for the highway department to have. I honestly, just not being educated about what the highway department has and doesn't have, didn't know how many things that it seems like you guys...
We don't have.
...are without. So it seems like a pill that at some point we're going to have to swallow, but just not something I was expecting.
If it's easier, I could break it up with attachments, basic machine with certain attachments this year and follow through next year with other attachments if that's more feasible. And ideally, you'd like to get it all in one shot just to get it out of the way.
Well, and didn't we see that there was a financing option?
Yep, you can...
lease purchase?
Yeah, lease purchase, four-year payments, or four annual payments, I should say.
And is it interest-free, or is there a penalty for doing it?
I believe it's interest-free. I don't have that exact answer.
I don't know why we wouldn't do that route, then.
Yeah, $90,000 is a lot, particularly this year.
I understand that.
Yeah, I mean, if there was a way to spread the payments, and it's interest-free, and we could, and the highway department gets what they need, and that gives the town a little bit more leverage, that's something that would be more palatable to me.
Well, it might extend the warranty, too, if you haven't completely paid for it.
It certainly might.
Wait a second, we still owe money on it.
It is a 10-year purchase. Most of our tractors and all that stuff, small dump trucks are 10 years. Our big dump trucks, our loaders, that's a 25-year purchase. Our lawnmowers are anywhere from 5 to 10, depending on how long they live. I don't look to replace this machine for at least 10 years.
Right.
So I don't know if that helps with some of the numbers.
I haven't seen any over sand pits. You can't go borrow one there.
So would you rather hold off on making a recommendation and let Rob go back and see if he can get a finance option?
I know there is a finance option. I don't have the exact details of it, but I can have that within 48 hours if that
helps.
That'd be helpful.
I can check my email.
I don't think it had like the interest rates or anything on it.
No, it was just a flat figure. Yeah.
But I can get you all of the detailed information.
Yeah, I'd rather hold off then.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I appreciate seeing that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we're not going to vote on that one.
All right, so you guys are going to hold off on that. How do you feel? I'm ready where I feel like I could make a recommendation.
Well, I'm for it, but I feel like the Finance Committee's got to do their work, and I wouldn't feel uncomfortable waiting for them.
No, I wouldn't feel uncomfortable waiting for them either, and it sounds like, but I support what Rob's trying to do, but I absolutely agree with the financing segment of it. If that's the way we can pull this off, that would be awesome.
Four-pay plan.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, especially if there's no interest. That seems like a no-brainer. Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll have all that information to you in 48 hours or so.
All right, so how would that work? Because
we'd have to amend it on the floor.
But we'd also not have a recommendation.
Right, so we'll just print 00, like a no vote.
Well, I'm ready to recommend it.
We could recommend it and, just, you know, come back on the floor and if things change.
We're going to be financing it instead.
I don't want to recommend $90,000 article.
There's a need.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Yeah.
And again, we sat at the town properties and went over this and felt the same way.
I think it's a nice addition. That's a big hunk of money in 1 year. If we're spreading this out over 3 or 4 years, I'm much more interested in supporting this. So not quite sure of the logistics. I think we could vote yes, knowing amongst ourselves that we were going to strongly support an amendment.
If we're going to wait for more information.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right.
All right, so you want to take a vote?
Yeah, so I'll make a motion that the selectmen support Article 10 with the hopes that Rob is able to come back with a lease-to-own amendment to this article for town meeting and for the Finance Committee.
Absolutely.
Thank you. I'll second that.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I keep wanting to say roll call vote.
So FinCom will be listed as 00?
They'll be listed as 00.
Okay.
Can I get a copy of the warrant so that I can follow along?
I don't have any printed. It's up on the screen, but I can email it to you.
Okay.
You want to come over here?
I can give you.
Yeah, I can forward you a new one.
You can come over here.
Perfect. Thank you.
Okay.
Is it okay if we do, let's see, 11, 12, 13, 14? A lot of these are all similar.
Why don't we do 11, 12 and then take CPC as a separate?
Yeah, let's
never
do
discuss
that.
It,
okay,
but that's
so 11 are the standard lease payments.
Okay, so those are
the fiber and the
for,
truck.
That Rob puts in every year for equipment that we already own?
Yeah, it's the, I think it might be the third year payment, it's the second year payment on the highway truck and the third year payment, I believe, on the fiber optic. And then, so that's just 11. And then, John, you want to do the CPC stuff separate?
Yeah, I'd like to take it as a group.
Okay, so let's just vote 11 then.
Are you okay with?
Yeah, we have already voted in favor of it.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 11 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And then 12 and 13, FinCom does not vote on. Right. And these are the standard, one is the regular CPC article, and then the other is to transfer the from the undesignated fund balance for land acquisition. And that one has been fully vetted by town council.
I'm okay with both of those.
And that was just what, adding, these aren't going to work, adding money to the article?
It's taking from undesignated funds and making it available for acquisition of land. And it's specifically for costs for like transfer, land donation. There's a lot of work that comes with that, like surveying, wetlands delineation.
It's basically just moving from one plot to the other. It's not raising or appropriate.
Well, and it helps speed up the process, too, if they find a parcel of land. Instead of
then they can act
town
on it.
Meeting, right. They can see if it's feasible. Okay. So are we all okay with Articles 12
and
13?
Yep.
Okay. I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 12 and 13 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
14, 15 are the standard Board of Assessors ones for their valuation work. And FinCom voted for those already.
So fiscal year 2024 and then $8,000. Then I have to put on my glasses.
No.
Thanks, John. Okay. All right. So no issues with 14 or 15? You're both good with that?
All good.
Fine.
Okay. I'll make a motion that the selectmen recommend Article 14 and 15 as printed in the warrant. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And did we have a second?
I'm sorry, I think I seconded.
Okay.
Maybe I didn't, I seconded.
16 and...
It was implied.
It was implied.
16 and 17 are for pilot agreements that the Board of Assessors has been working on.
What was 18?
And these have been vetted by our solar council.
Okay, so that's the Upland Road, and then the other one is Ring Road?
Yes.
Is that the school one?
I don't know.
No.
We never talk about it.
Yes.
So we need a little more information.
Any questions or concerns on those?
No.
Okay.
No, go ahead.
Okay.
We never discussed this in opioid settlement stabilization fund.
16 and 17 is printed in the warrant.
Second?
Neither do I.
All in favor?
So we'll see what they say. Who's it from?
18 is for the opioid settlement. Basically, the money that we get in now, there's no real legal mechanism to have access to it, so town council is suggesting that all of the communities participating in the settlement adopt this language so that the money can eventually be accessed.
Was it like a revolving account, something like that?
Very similar.
In effect, there's no money effect at this point, though.
There is money that the town has already taken in...
We've taken it?
...for this, but right now, it's just sitting and it kind of doesn't have a home, so to speak.
Okay.
And FinCom already recommended this?
No, we didn't, because we didn't know anything about it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we take in money, we're part of a nationwide settlement agreement, most of the cities and towns in the Commonwealth are, but right now, there's no legal mechanism to access the funds. So council is having all of their member communities adopt this language, so that then the money will eventually make it to this, basically, it's like a stabilization fund, and it can only be used for very specific purposes in relation to, like, preventing drug abuse and things like that.
And the money has come in?
We've already received money.
Are we going to be raising money for that fund?
No.
No.
No, it's just money that we get paid by large pharmaceutical companies...
Okay.
...as part of this nationwide settlement. So no town money is involved.
Can this be used towards the DIP program?
We think it might be able to. We looked at a very preliminary list of potential uses for it, and that was, like, the main one that we could identify that seemed applicable.
Steve, we're going to have to vote on this article, on 18.
I'm off.
Feel like you're ready to take a vote on it?
Yes, I think we're ready to take a vote on 18.
Yeah.
Is there a motion?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Unanimous, okay.
Questions or concerns on 18?
No concerns.
Okay, all right, I'll make a motion, the selectmen recommend Article 18 is printed in the warrant.
Second?
All in favor?
Aye.
19 is to make changes to the groundwater protection district, and planning board won't be holding their hearing on this, I don't think for a couple weeks, but it was put forth by bylaw review committee and the planning board. Typically, you vote on the bylaw ones.
I did sit with Alan Wheelock twice to go through this, because I tried reading it and I was totally lost. And he convinced me that, in effect, it's straightening out some of the inconsistencies we have, and that it's going to also be integrated with our earth removal bylaw, so that there's nothing that conflicts. After spending some time, I feel very comfortable voting it.
I read it, too, and reading it in preparation for the earth removal, I was concerned that there were, it wasn't really consistent, and I felt like it needed to be, there were areas of it that really needed to be tougher, that they've addressed in this go-around, so I liked what they came up with for this revision of the groundwater protection bylaw. Did you get a chance to read it, Mark?
I would say I've skimmed it and I'm comfortable with it.
Okay, all right. Seems like we're all supportive of this, so I'll make a motion, the selectmen recommend the Article, what is it, 19 list?
19.
19 as printed in the warrant.
Second?
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. And then 20 is to amend the definition section of the bylaws.
Yeah.
So that's pretty straightforward.
I like that too, a lot. All right, any questions or concerns about 20? Tightening up the definitions?
Very much well-needed one. Glad it's there.
Yeah, yep. Me too. All right, so I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 20 is printed in the warrant.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
'21 and '22, FinCom already voted, and these are to replenish the two fire department articles that we see every year for the breathing apparatus and the personal protective equipment.
Except for you.
All right. Any questions or concerns on those?
No. Glad we're spread them out and working on a continual basis.
You're okay with
it. We voted, in favorably.
Yeah.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 21 and Article 22 as submitted in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Now, I think FinCom was holding 23 and 24.
Mm-hmm.
On the special, the fire department wants to repurpose any funds left in the Engine 1 refurbishment article to make it available for anything. So I think the Finance Committee's standpoint was, well, could those funds, would there be enough left over in there to address these? There may be. I spoke with John Schursted from the Fire Department today, but that project on Engine 1 isn't finished yet, so we won't know. So I'm wondering if we should just keep these on the warrant, but maybe you don't vote, and then at town meeting we may be able to pass over them if there's enough money left in the account for the other project.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm. I'm comfortable with that.
Yeah.
Are you, I like that.
Can come okay with that?
We all right, so we'll do no vote on 23 and 24.
All right, so should I make a motion that we do not recommend it at this time, or?
I would just say let's just not
take
vote.
A vote.
Yeah,
okay,
and so I'll just put 00.
Okay.
I'll go back and do that.
So we'll list that as no vote taken, is that?
Well, it'll be 00, similar to how the FinCom vote shows up on the one for Rob's machine.
So should we take a vote, though, saying
maybe to
we're
pass
not,
over?
We're,
to not make a recommendation.
To not make a recommendation.
Okay,
right.
Sure.
So we'll be in favor of not taking
it.
Yes,
right.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
All right, so I'll make a motion. The selectmen vote to not make a recommendation on Articles 23 and 24.
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
'25 is to replenish our general consultant and design services article. This was one that was put forth by Town Properties a couple years ago, and it just makes it so that we have funds available to us when, say, for example, we find out that the library doesn't have a leaching field. We're able to get an engineer involved right away to work on things like that. So this will bring it back up to around, I believe $12,000 will be in it. At that point, it'll replenish it back up to that standard amount.
Is this the article that we were going to use to address if anything happened in Carver with?
No,
okay,
that money's still sitting
okay,
there.
Okay. All right, it makes sense to me. Do you have any questions or concerns on it?
No.
All right. Make a motion. The selectmen recommend article. Did Finance Committee recommend this?
We have not voted on that article. Is there money?
You guys go first.
Is there money in the account now?
Yes. I believe if we get the 9,000, it'll bring it back up to around 12,000 and change. So like 12 or 13,000. We've been using it steadily for all the problems that we've been having at all of the town buildings.
I guess it's just the terminology, general consultant preliminary design article. It was just a little bit vague, so we hadn't voted.
So that was the name of the article back like a couple years ago when it was originally proposed. So that's why council has us keep the same name. But it's really for consulting and engineering services every time something goes wrong here.
Okay. You want to vote on it? You comfortable with it? I think so.
Okay. Then I'll make a motion.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 25 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Rest of these are.
26 is, and I'm just looking, you guys voted that one.
Yes.
26 is for the replacement of the roof on the front portion of this building. And the reason, part of the reason why it's so high, it does include everything. It's all inclusive of all the design services, but it's also for the hazardous materials mitigation because that part of the building is so old. So that will finish it completely.
Yeah, John said that's what gutters and fascia.
It's everything. It's all the drainage.
What is that one?
Okay. Questions or concerns?
No concern.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 26 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I will say we don't expect it to come in quite that high, but we don't know.
Just looking here. So FinCom voted through 33.
Okay.
So maybe you can do some of these as a group.
Okay.
So 27 is for continued interior building improvements and flooring projects at the library to continue what we've already started. 28 is for installation of alarm systems at the highway barn. Last year, we funded for library and highway, but they had a lot of issues at the library, so we used all the money on that. 29 is to add $15,000 to our IT and equipment article so that we can continue with our software and hardware updates. And it's also incorporates some funds in case we need something for potentially going to a hybrid meeting option in the future. Do you want to just do those and then?
I think so.
Okay. And FinCom has recommended all these articles?
Yes.
All right. So this is 27.
27, 28.
And 29.
29.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 27, 28, and 29 as printed in the warrant.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
30 is to do phase one of book replacement at the library. This one's specific to the children's nonfiction collection. Mike Slosson also wants to replace the adult nonfiction collection. But the total cost for the entire project is around $150,000. And after looking at all of the town finances and also how long it will take him to actually recatalog all the new books, he thought that $25,000 to get him started would be good. In the children's collection specifically, some of the books are like not factual any longer. Like the data is outdated.
They're old.
Yeah, it's old.
So am I. So am I.
Yeah, me too.
So did Finance Committee recommend Article 30?
Yes.
Okay. All right. Any questions or concerns on 30?
No, I appreciate spreading it out over time and making that a yearly thing.
Yeah, truly a project.
It is.
I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article, what is that?
30.
30?
Yep.
As printed in the warrant.
I'm sorry, second.
That's all right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And then we can do probably 31 through 33 together. 31 is for the Recreation Committee so that they have the funds available since they need to do most of their work in the spring. We're always like off a season in terms of town meeting funding. So this will actually be used to get them up and running next spring. And this spring, they're using the recreation earmark that was put in the state budget for them. So this will bring them up to date for next year. So there's that one. And then 32 is to replace the flooring in three classrooms at Dennett.
Which one?
And 33 is for the town clerk's bylaw codification subscription.
Why did we all have 34?
Did Finance Committee recommend these articles?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm fine with them.
Any questions or concerns on these?
No concerns. Glad the rec is up and moving and funded, or potentially funded.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 31, 32, and 33 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
I don't either.
So 34 is for an HVAC unit at Silver Lake, but we're thinking that we might be able to use ARPA funds for that.
That's why.
So I don't know if you want to hold or take a vote not to do anything with it, and then we think we can probably just pass over it. That's the plan.
It says or transfer from available funds, so.
But ARPA is not a town meeting funding source, so we would just do that separately. We'd pass over it at town meeting and just use the ARPA funds.
All right.
From the county.
Yeah.
So, and we should know by town meeting?
We'll know.
Okay, whether the ARPA funds will be available? Okay. All right, did Finance Committee make a recommendation?
We did not vote on that.
We held.
We held on.
Do you feel comfortable taking the same action, holding off until town meeting?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so I'll let you guys take your non-vote first.
Right.
So I'll make a motion that we don't recommend this.
We haven't already.
I know.
But go ahead.
Okay. Or whatever the wording needs to be, that we are not voting on it now.
Yeah.
Vote to make no recommendation.
Yeah, to vote that. Thank you for the language.
Mm-hmm.
I'll second that.
Okay, all in favor of holding Article 34?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, unanimous.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen vote to not make a recommendation on Article 34 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
35 is for the Silver Lake Middle School for our portion of the cost for the resource officer. Finance already voted.
You already voted it? Okay.
Do it every year now.
All right. I'll make a motion. The selectmen support article or recommend Article 35 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And then 36, this is to clean up language that we had approved at a prior town meeting. Council had an issue with the way something was worded, so this fixes that. It was from one of the articles on the special that authorizes the treasurer to do the tax title agreements.
All right, so Finance Committee's not going to make a recommendation.
No.
It's not a money article. Are you okay with this one, too?
I am.
Yep.
All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 36 is printed in the warrant.
Second.
Roll call, all in favor?
Aye.
So that's it for the annual.
Okay, great. And you're running again? Your name's on the ballot?
Oh, is it on the ballot?
Is it?
Well, yes, it is.
Okay, all right. So do you want to go to the budget now?
Sure. So this is the Finance Committee voted budget.
What, the green?
The green.
Okay.
They are recommending every item as requested. There was one, let me find it here. The Highway Department Administrative Assistant had put in for a 16.7% increase, and Finance Committee was recommending the 5% increase that was recommended for all of the wage and personnel employees. Last year, when we did the salary adjustments for the wage and personnel employees, the highway superintendent, his administrative assistant did get a large increase, but it was for an increase in hours. She was not moved to the top of the range for her position. So that's why she was seeking the increase this year. It would move her to the top of the range.
Okay, so it's still in the range for the position. It's just moving her to the top.
It would be moving her to the very top.
How long has Colleen been doing the job, Rob?
16 years.
How much?
No.
Colleen?
Highway?
Yeah.
16 years?
She started there before here.
I didn't know that. Interesting.
Yeah. I put her in for it. I think she's worth it. She comes in on her days off to meet people for stickers. She works far more hours than she's paid for. She's a good employee. I think it's only like a $2,000 difference for the year. She's got a lot of experience, and she goes above and beyond.
I don't know how recommending, but so finance, the finance committee
will
is
have the main motion at town meeting. So this would need to be an amended.
So someone would have to hold.
Someone would have
this
to put
line.
A hold on her line.
Okay. Which would probably be Rob.
Unless finance, but I think that they felt strongly, correct me if I'm wrong, that because it's this, you wanted to keep it uniform for all the wage and personnel employees.
Okay. Yeah, which
so
I understand.
They would need to do an alternate motion.
Okay.
If they wanted to.
Okay.
To try that at town meeting.
Okay. So that's what you'll do then. Okay. That makes sense. Okay. All right. So there's really nothing for us to do. It's just enough.
Not really.
Okay. Okay.
I mean, unless you had any specific questions, but
no.
You've seen the budget.
No.
So
yes.
The requested and the recommended are pretty much in agreement throughout?
Pretty much.
Agreement throughout.
So can we just highlight the ones that?
Just do one. Yeah, it was only the highway administrative assistant that's not.
There's nothing else in the budget?
No.
Wow.
We did a good job this year, John.
That's right. Yeah, well done. Well done. Teamwork. Okay. Great. So that's the only discrepancy.
Yeah, so if you want to take a vote for Article 4, which is the budget, to recommend it.
Okay. Does the selectmen recommend the budget? As printed in the warrant?
Printed, well, it's Article 4.
It's Article 4.
As noted in Article 4.
Okay. All right. So any questions or concerns about that?
No.
Okay. All right. So I make a motion the selectmen recommend Article 4 as printed in the warrant?
Yes.
Second.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right.
Can I just note that maybe that's a four-page document, and it's a year's worth of work on those people and Liz and... an amazing.
Well, really, the department heads too. Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah.
So maybe the town-wide effort, but then all encapsulated in four pages.
Right, exactly. And a lot of meetings to discuss, and really at nauseam, probably.
It does feel like we've made a lot of progress in the town administrator and the finance committee integrating in and making this happen. So
absolutely.
It's kind of pretty easy when we sit here.
It's a big help.
It's great. All right, so now we're on the special.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now we're on the special.
Do we know what's going to be moving between what departments?
No.
We don't. Okay, because it's hard to know.
So most of these will be funded either from other funding sources or from free cash.
Okay. And we're not doing that tonight. We're just voting the okay.
Yeah, I think funding source to be identified
right
down the road.
Right.
And did finance already vote on all of these?
They put a hold on
we put a hold on several.
11 and 12.
Okay.
Is that right?
And 5.
Oh, and 5. I'm sorry, you added that one.
All right, 1, 5, 11, and 12?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so do we want to jump into 1 and
sure.
An explanation?
So this is for the old townhouse roof replacement. We already raised $100,000 at the special town meeting back in November. This is a really high estimate, but the project's out to bid right now. Bids come in Wednesday. So we can, you can amend down on the floor of town meeting, but you can't amend up. So just to be extra careful that we're able to complete the project, we were putting this in for 150.
We had a concern, a fair number of concerns about this, because the building basically is not being used. We know we have to, the roof is going to have to be maintained, but it's a lot of money for a building that you want to either find a way to use it or sell it or do something with it. I don't know what the plans are, but there should probably be some.
We've tried to, you know, the Town Properties Committee has wrestled with how do we put people in there.
Yeah.
It's used by a few of the organizations, the fitness class, the yoga, the mediation, but, you know, that's maybe 4, 5, 6 hours a week, and that's it. And we just haven't come up with an idea. We talked to Council on Aging. Would that make sense? But they're only there a couple of days, and sometimes it's just the one clerk because the council isn't meeting there. You know, they meet once a month. So really, we're looking for town input. What should we be doing with this beautiful old building?
It is a beautiful, yeah. Mm-hmm.
One of the problems you note in that building is, especially for the seniors, if you want to use that big upstairs room, it's a climb.
It is, and there's...
And not all of them can just run up there.
You know, we put in the chair, I guess, quite a long time ago, but yeah. There's seniors who won't use it because they feel unbalanced.
Yeah.
You know, and it's...
So it's a lot of money to be spending, so I think something needs to be done with this building. Some plans or something.
The roof does need to be fixed. I agree with you.
The roof needs to be fixed.
We do need to figure out a use of the building.
Right. So that's really why we put a hold on it. I mean, let's talk about this. What are we going to do about it? We don't have to talk about it tonight, but it's a concern.
It's definitely.
I hear that concern. On the other hand, unless we protect this building, it's going to be worth nothing, either to us or anyone else.
But we have to come up with a way to do something with this building instead of just pouring money into it.
I agree. You know, it's been there a long time, and we found uses in the past. Something's going to show up sooner or later, and I think you've put us on alert that we may have to make it come up sooner to keep Finance Committee happy.
Well, and then another question that we just had, I know, John Wilhelmsen was in here and did speak, you know, on behalf of the Town Properties Committee, but was this formally put out in a request for proposal, or was there any?
It's out for bids.
Yeah, it's out for bid right now.
So we've never seen anything, and I probably missed it then, and that's probably my fault. But that outlined what the requirements for to submit a bid and what the specifications were, or anything.
So we use an online platform when we work with this particular architect. We use Bid Docs Online.
Okay.
But it is out right now.
Is it on the town website, or is it in a newspaper?
So they do all of that. We did put notice in the newspaper and notice on Combis, and it went into the central register.
Okay.
But it just directs people to Bid Docs Online.
Right, right. Okay, I must have just missed it in the newspaper when it came out, but I'd just be interested to read through what the specs actually
are. Sure, we can give you that.
I can send you a copy of
the
info.
That'd be helpful.
One of the problems there is there's not much land with it. You know, you have a real parking problem. I mean, over time, Jack Doyle has been kind enough to let us use his field, but...
I think those days are gone.
So you're right. We need to noodle how to get, what are we going to do with this thing?
Right. Does this building have historical value to the town?
It's built in 1850. It was the original town hall. Prior to 1850, they met in the church.
It's beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Parsonage. So this is the first devoted town hall. And...
I wonder if we could find a better use, like maybe even affordable housing apartments or something like that in the building, because I just don't see this being a good use for seniors. But then you've got a lot of
you got the
stuff
same,
in there that would have to be moved out.
Well, you could work with that, but you'd have the same problem with affordable housing. You'd have to put in an elevator. And we looked at that way back when Kathy Lenatra came and said, you know, I'd like to work with you. And I said, fine, we need an elevator. And then we found out it was like $250,000, and she was talking, you know, somewhere under $100,000. That's why we have a ramp going up here, because the earmark, we just couldn't put it forward to the old townhouse. We put it here.
So
I always thought it'd make a great doctor's office, but, you know.
I guess we have to vote. Someone want to make a motion?
I'll make a motion to approve Article 1.
Is there a second?
Yeah, I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, we approved it. Reluctantly, but we approved it.
I think that
I understand your reluctance.
Have our charge here that we need to find something suitable for that building besides how it's being currently used, because that really isn't a suitable use of the building.
I agree.
Okay. Okay. All right. So I'll make a motion that the selectmen approve Article 1 as printed in the warrant, or recommend Article 1 as printed in the warrant.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Let's see. 2 is the one that we see each year. It's just to replenish the town building maintenance emergency article. Finance already voted this one. And then Article 3 is to add $6,000 to the unemployment line. And that's to cover some unanticipated unemployment costs, since we're self-insured for unemployment. And then Article 4, I don't know if you want to do maybe just these three in a batch.
That
Article 4 is for $10,000 to OPEB.
And that's the traditional.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. I would be curious as to in what century we will have that fully funded.
The OPEB.
At these, yeah, at yeah, this, at
then
these
I just
numbers,
wonder if it's even worth funding it.
I know.
I mean, it's a many millions of dollars. So,
I know.
On the other hand, it is a gesture.
Yeah, it is a gesture, but.
And if nothing else, keeps it at least once a year that we think about it a little bit. A
little
least.
Bit. Kind All right. Bit. So I'll make a motion that the selectmen recommend Article 2, Article 3, and Article 4 as printed in the warrant.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 5, FinCom had put the hold on. This
okay,
was
this
the
was
one that
the
we talked
one?
About. Yeah.
Okay. Well,
I don't know if you want
to like
release
to hear
your
more
hold
about it too.
So this is the one that they think they're going to have enough money left over in it that they could address the frame for engine 2 and the tires that were on the annual.
Okay.
So you took no vote on those, but they won't know the balance in this until closer to town.
You're not necessarily against this. You just
no,
want to
we
see
just
the
did
funding.
Not vote and, we did not vote at all on
sure.
that.
Sure. Okay.
So would you like to do like you did the last to not make a recommendation and then we'll just hear maybe more about it at town meeting?
Yes.
Okay.
Would you
mm-hmm.
agree?
Yeah, that's fine.
All in favor?
Yeah.
You made a motion, right?
Sure. Well, should I not?
Oh, you can't make the motion.
Yeah.
Sorry.
I'll have to make the motion.
Steve, make the motion?
Yeah, I'll
okay.
make the motion. I'll second.
Yeah.
All right, so the three of us all in favor?
Yeah, aye.
Okay, one abstain.
Right. Mm-hmm. All right. I'll make a recommendation that the selectmen vote to not make a recommendation on Article 5 in the
second.
Special town meeting warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 And 6 is for a new copier scanner for inspectional services.
Which is inspectional services?
Like
the building?
Building,
okay.
Planning, conservation. It's
okay.
Like the whole upstairs.
The whole upstairs, okay. I didn't know if we had
and
a new
FinCom
department.
And FinCom already voted this. We can probably group some of these.
And this is a straight out purchase?
Yes.
This is not a lease?
Correct. Okay. 7 is for the remaining cost of the new generator for this building, and The rest of it is coming from the town building maintenance emergency article. So that's been ordered and should be here soon, hopefully. And then, let's see, 8 is for unpaid bills from a prior fiscal year. I think this number is going to come down a little bit. But we can amend down, we can't amend up. So
that's why don't that we just one. Vote those three?
And okay.
Want to just do those?
So no ARPA money for the generator?
So we can look at that, like taking a portion of it from ARPA, but I think we wanted to
have a bulk of the money squared away?
Yeah, and be able to use those funds on the well project.
Gotcha.
And then we have the other well issue.
Well, we've
currently
got so many balls in the air, it's
yeah,
really.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you're okay with those, Mark?
Yes.
And you're okay with those, John? Okay, so I'll make a motion the selectmen recommend Article 7.
Six, seven, and eight
as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
9 is to add funds to the management positions article, and this will cover Lance Benjamino's services on the fire chief position.
And
finance voted this
made
one.
You recommended this?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. Any questions or concerns on this one?
No.
Okay.
No.
I'll make a motion the selectmen recommend Article 9 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
10 and 11, FinCom held. They didn't vote these.
Okay.
One is to cover the fire chief's expected buyout.
Marilyn is saying.
We voted 10. Maybe I gave
you
the.
Oh, you did. Okay. I'm sorry. That didn't get put on Lisa's list. She put hold.
Okay.
Okay, so 10
okay,
is.
Okay, so 10 you're okay with. So that's the fire
right.
chief money to cover his buyout.
This is the sick time or vacation, whatever the buyout is. Okay.
We don't want to.
All right, any
no concern.
Questions or
nope.
concerns on that?
Nope.
All right, and this is, I believe, a contractual obligation
right.
of these boards. All right, so I'll make a motion the selectmen recommend Article 10 as printed in the warrant.
Second.
We're for the state.
Aye.
Like that.
Oh, wait, no, I lied. I have it here. They voted to hold 11 and 12.
Okay.
Print was really small. So 11 was to supplement the fire and EMS salaries line. We expect them to be over budget again this year. Right now, I think we're a little over 75% through the fiscal, and I think that they're about 84% spent. They are going to be getting a reimbursement, though, from a grant to cover some of John Schurstead's time working on different projects, so that will help offset. But we weren't sure how over budget they would be. Historically, it's been, they've had a difficult time sticking to their budget. So, you know, we didn't want to leave it all for the reserve fund at the end, but.
Do you feel comfortable with that, having it potentially come out of the reserve fund?
Article 10?
11.
11? 11.
We were really looking for more information on the figure, but which is why we
sure.
didn't vote.
Sure.
Voted, but do you have any more idea?
I don't think it'll be much more than that, to be honest. I was happy to hear that they have grant funding coming in to cover some of his time.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, they've been fully reimbursed for their time on Cisco.
That's
and we don't have anything really left from that COVID money. Like that bailed them out last year.
And there's no modifications they can make to finish up the year to stay within budget?
I think that they're in a time of transition,
okay.
so I think that they're having
okay.
some difficulties.
Okay.
Yeah.
You want to vote on it? $20,000?
Do you want me to vote on it or no?
No.
Okay.
I'll make the motion.
All right. You make the motion.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All right. It's 3.
Okay.
So it can't be over $20,000. That's the most we can
right.
transfer
correct.
To them.
Okay. Correct. The rest would need to come from reserve fund or from other lines.
Okay. But you think that hopefully that will cover it, the 20,000?
I hope so.
Hope so. Okay.
Catherine, did you abstain from when, at your last meeting, when for on Article 10 for the fire chief?
I think she did. All of the fire department articles.
I'm sure that any fire ones are in there as 3-0 before I send it to print.
I was on the department for 30 years. Did that make a difference?
No.
No. We don't have any financial gain.
No.
Make Article 11?
Are you both okay with Article 11?
Yep.
Okay. All right, I'll make a motion. The selectmen recommend Article 11 is printed in the warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And then 12 is for all of the customary local school committee transfers, specifically for their special education budget. But we don't know yet. They think that they're going to be able possibly to fully fund this through other budget lines in the school budget because they implemented a spending freeze and they have money left over that they know about in the voc ed budget. But we won't know until closer to town meeting. So that's why it's written like this. Town council helped us with this.
Okay.
I can put in the ending part actually.
So do we want to wait to town meeting? Is that?
I mean, you might want to just because we think that the number for that they're going to need is somewhere in the $60,000 range, but they think they can fully fund it through the existing school budget. So I don't know if you want to maybe do no vote.
I would feel more comfortable going into town meeting and finding out what the real numbers are.
I think that makes sense.
We did not vote on this one either.
All right. Do you want to take a vote to not make a recommendation?
I'll make a motion to not do a recommendation now.
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
It's unanimous.
I'll make a motion to selectmen do not make a recommendation on Article 12 in the special town meeting warrant.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. That's it.
Every time I say
wow.
Ooh.
So I'll access to a printer at some point, like later tonight or tomorrow, and then if I put the signature page, I'm not sure how you want to work that. Printer now. You want me to print the signature pages like right now, or right after the meeting, or if you want to come in and sign at some point tomorrow.
Get easy on yourself. What do you want us to do?
It's easier if we try to figure.
Was I being too nitpicky?
No. Maybe when you guys are finishing up,
the only individual thing
go. I'll run and get it.
Yeah, because all you need is the signature pages.
Yeah.
Okay. I was fine with that.
All right. So is that everything that we've got with Finance Committee?
Yes.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
Great job.
See you at town meeting. Yeah. Excellent job.
This isn't like the old days, Marilyn, when you and I were on.
I know.
This is pretty good.
I want to go.
Almost professional.
Yeah, isn't it?
Almost,
nice?
Yeah.
There aren't any cookies.
We've come a long way.
That's right.
With us
thank you guys very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
You too. All right, so next item on our agenda is the MBTA.
Everything in my report was one number off, because I didn't have number 7.
Why don't we take a minute?
That's why.
Well, everybody clears out.
Yeah.
I can
take a break from it.
Rearrange
sure.
The numbers.
You want to take a break?
All right.
John, is his name?
I didn't have a number 7.
John, we're going to take a 2-minute break.
Guys.
All right, I'll make a motion we take a 2-minute break.
2 or 5?
2.
Want me to
I said 5, but John said 2.
I'm going to run and print this stuff.
Well, yeah, let's make it 3. So
okay,
it has
2.5.
Yeah.
All right, so we're back from a brief break. Next item on our agenda is the MBTA Community Zoning Requirements and Next Steps. So this is something we discussed at our last agenda with the understanding that we were going to, we really didn't have a whole lot of information that we were going to talk about it again tonight.
So I spoke with our representative from Old Colony Planning Council We are receiving technical assistance from them to get this off the ground. Apparently, there is no option for opting out that seems viable at this point in time. And in order for them to help us with the next required step, they're going to need to know in relatively short order where we think we could potentially zone for this type of housing allotment in the future. So we wouldn't be doing the zoning itself right now. That would be like next year's town meeting. But we do have to provide a location. So they've provided us with a map. And what I would propose, I've been talking with Alan Wheelock and Ann Subaluski in their capacities as bylaw review and planning board. I think if you could authorize me to put together a small group of us internally to work with the person from Old Colony Planning Council and at least complete this preliminary step, get something very general on paper so that we're in compliance, I think that that's the best way to move forward, because they need, Old Colony would need basically a say-so from us of a potential location for this type of zoning overlay, probably by like town meeting time. The person who's working on it is leaving them at the end of May, which is unfortunate.
Very unfortunate.
So they need to have this wrapped. And it wouldn't be etched in stone. It's not the language for the zoning overlay itself. It's simply getting a location on paper.
So would you come back with one location or a couple of locations?
I think ideally maybe just one, just so we can check this off the list and move forward. You could always do more in the future. Like when it got time to go to town meeting next year, to actually have the overlay district created and implemented, at that point it would give us an entire year for bylaw review to look at it, some of our other boards and committees, and maybe say, you know, okay, it makes sense. If we're doing it as an overlay, maybe there are more than one location in town that it would make sense.
So if you picked one and later on you wanted to change it, can you do that?
I would think so. I mean, this is such a preliminary stage in the process, but it seems like I was asking, like, well, what if we needed an extension? And it's like, no, like, there's no opportunity for that. Even on completing this first step, because to me it seems a little silly if we identify a location that, like, you want it to mean something. You don't want to pick just some arbitrary location just to check off a box, but apparently they do need to know, like I said, in short order. I mean, the person who's assisting us with this, she's a fantastic resource with all things housing related, but she's leaving there at the end of May and has to enter in whatever spot we identify in town. She then needs to plug in like actual parcel IDs. There's a lot of specific information that she has to do the legwork on. And apparently there's some, I'm not that well versed in this, I just know like the very top layer of it, but I guess there's this compliance model with the state that needs to be filled in.
My concern is whatever we pick is not going to be town owned. We don't have enough land ourselves to do it.
Correct, and it seems odd. There is an odd component to saying, oh, we're going to potentially in the future rezone or create an overlay over other people's property.
Right, exactly.
There would be a public process for that, and obviously those people would all be notified. I think that this is very conceptual. This is just, hey, if you had to create a zoning overlay that facilitates multiple housing units, where in your town would make sense to do that? And ideally, they want to see it close to the train station, but that's not really super
applicable.
It's not
applicable. Realistic.
It's not. No. I mean, the only thing that came to mind for me was maybe over towards like the interchange with 44 and Spring Street, like Cisco, like the industrial area. Maybe that's a safe bet if it's
on
just
either
the
side
industrial.
Of the highway. Yeah.
And that way you're not suggesting private residential parcels.
That certainly
keep
would
it just to the industrial, maybe.
Yeah, it would fly better, that's for sure.
I don't know. They're putting us in a, it's just timing-wise. I know we've known about this for a while, but as far as finding out we got the technical assistance and then getting this off the ground, I mean, it's not like we've been sitting on this for any amount of time. It's just,
it's really
moving really fast, and I don't feel like our town, where we have no municipal sewer or water, just that alone, I don't know that it makes it. It's hard to fit us into the mold that they want us to fit into.
And they're not being flexible at all.
And I don't think it's that, you know, I think everybody here supports the creation of housing and certainly affordable housing, whether age qualified or not. It's not about creating housing. It's the density that they're looking for, and having to turn this around in such a short amount of time. I don't know, it's putting us in a predicament, but I don't know if maybe we'd be better taking a safe approach and just identifying the pre-existing industrial and saying, well, yeah, we could put an overlay there. I mean, it's not a mandate to build, it's a mandate to zone. So even if you picked a spot that realistically somebody may not be interested in doing that type of project, but again, that seems strange, like we're going to do that just to check a box and say that we're...
Do we own land? Industrial land?
No.
No, it's all private.
Okay.
There's no place in town we own big enough.
But there's no... This legislation doesn't require this be town-owned land. It's just a district where
this
could be done.
Just an overlay. But to adopt the overlay, like, you'd have to put all legal language to it and everything, and that would be a very public process with public input. That would go through two public hearing processes. It would go before the planning board. It would go to town meeting. So it's not like that. The zoning in and of itself would not get adopted without public input and vote. But then I wonder what happens there, and no one's really answered that for me. I said, well, what if we go through this exercise so we stay in compliance, and then next year we go to town meeting with an overlay and the people vote no? Like, what happens in your town if town meeting says no?
Yeah.
Which I think is one of the many issues on this legislation that's really flawed and that kind of is evolving. We had 10 days ago or so an opinion from the state attorney general that there would be more consequences to towns that didn't do this beyond lack of grants or potentially losing grants. This legislation has such a good purpose in mind and really envisioned housing very close to train stations so people could walk to them. For a town like Plumpton that just happens to be next door, it doesn't work very well. And for a little tiny town without infrastructure, with a school system that probably would just be wrecked if we added 30 or 40 or 50 more kids, this one's really, really hard. And I know there are towns that are deciding not to do this, and I think we have to take this first step, but I think the bigger level of could it be that the consequences of not doing this are less than, or the consequences of doing this wouldn't stop us from not doing it. I mean, I totally agree with you. I think the first step of putting together a small group and moving ahead, but I think this is open in the big thinking on what is ultimately going to be the best way to achieve the goal we want to achieve.
I support the idea of a committee, but I rather than just getting to an endpoint and then giving it to us, there needs to be input along the way.
I agree.
Because I feel like there's...
Well, we don't have a lot of time for input.
No, but there's... If we identify something and we can't change it later, that would...
That's problematic.
Well, and can they legally force us to do this?
Well, and I think that's the piece that's a really interesting question. And
if we don't have town-owned property, we can't speak for other people's property.
Well, and
we can't even make a commitment for our own property.
No,
right
now. We make zoning regulations, whether it's residential agriculture versus industrial. I mean, that's...
It is the attraction of if we go ahead with this, zoning down toward the industrial area that, so that residents are the least affected possible. I mean, this legislation is so blind to a little tiny town that has a lot of wetlands, that has no infrastructure. It just, it's patently unfair.
It's all that, but it's not aimed at us. You know, it's aimed at the Foxboroughs.
Yeah, but we're the fallout.
And but we have to live with it.
And we're the consequence of it. And that's the piece that I think our state representatives and senator understand, that this just isn't fair at this point.
I did happen to have a conversation with Kathy Lenatra when she was doing her library tour. And she made a comment that this is real. You really don't have an option. You need to do it.
Yeah, and that's just.
And this conversation came up last week with
Susan Moran.
Right.
Yeah. Susan Moran as well, Senator Susan Moran.
I think we should get on with the committee, but, you know, give us a chance to input, whether it's just you talking to us individually or whatever.
So I'm glad to make a motion.
Okay.
So I make a motion that we authorize Liz to put together a small group to work with Old Colony Planning Council on the first step of envisioning a zoning district to comply with MBTA ordinances.
I'll second. All in favor?
Aye.
I just wonder if we too should reach out to Copeland and Page on this.
Want me to?
Yeah, and see if there's anything, any wiggle room here for establishing some type of criteria for towns under a certain population.
Well, I had wondered even about getting an extension on even this first step. I mean, the individual from OCPC who is assigned to us, she's fantastic with all things housing, but I think we're being sped up because that's who's assigned to us. And I don't know, like, I feel like we should have.
When's it actually due?
I think June 30th.
Okay.
But I think her last day is like June 2nd.
Yeah,
and
yeah, right.
Yeah, so I think we're kind of a casualty of that as well. So I don't know, like even an extension beyond that. I mean, we're a little tiny town, and that was what I put in our application for the technical assistance. I said, we don't have a professional planner on staff.
Right.
Or people to do this on the day-to-day. But I was told no, that that doesn't count as extenuating circumstances, and this is just the first step. It's conceptual.
We just
don't
want
to get locked into something later because we thought we had to rush. But if we don't get it to her in time to fill in all the information and do the legwork before she leaves, she basically said, no, you guys are done. Like, we're out of the process at that point. So I don't want to get stuck, and we don't know how to use this compliance model.
I don't know if there's anybody else there that could fill in for her. And, I mean, we only get another 30 days.
Right.
It's still a rush job, this whole thing.
It is.
But I just wonder if they're overstepping the Attorney General, if they really don't have the authority through this legislation to force us to do it, for because it just doesn't make sense for us.
It totally
we're being
doesn't.
Put in a position that is it's just not attainable for the town. And it's just us checking a box so that we can, because they're holding this money over our head that if we don't do it, we're going to be out grant money, we're going to be out public works money, and that's really not
the part that I found alarming was that there could be other consequences beyond. Like, even the grant funding, you could make a judgment call if you felt like that funding was applicable to us or not anyway. But the fact that there could be other penalties imposed
just seems like a lot of threats.
I think we want to be very careful that we don't. I think I agree with everything you say, but I think
we want to be in compliance at least now.
They don't want any town walking away and saying, you know, and there's about three or four that have already said, I'm not sure Halifax has agreed to even fill it out.
Oh, they're pretty upset about it.
Right.
They are. Middleborough is.
Middleborough said no, right?
I wouldn't be a bit surprised if some of these towns joined together and tried to fight this, because it's not fair.
Let's us at least try to see if we can fill it out. I would be opposed to saying, no, we're not going to do it.
No, I think at this point, though, I'd like to leave that on the table as a possibility. And maybe some of this is just continuing to speak to our legislative people and just keep making the case. And in the meantime, moving ahead with compliance, knowing that we're not committed to anything yet, and push will come to shove next year at town meeting.
Yeah, well. Yeah,
okay.
All right. So you made the motion. You had a question, Deb?
Yeah. I'm worried that if you put something down in paper and say, okay, we'll take these parcels and include those in, and it is private property, is that the first step to it on the domain? Could they make us?
That's an interesting point.
I think it gets to a constitutional issue pretty quickly, and I that's why I think this is an evolving thing.
Yeah, that's all.
Yeah. Well, what if we limited it to town property and we said, this is what we have? We got virtually nothing.
What if we sent them the list of the town-owned parcels, like the three or four that we had looked at, John?
What, like on Center Street and?
Like Old Brook Street and Center Street.
A few people here and a few people there.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
what if we send that and we say these are the only town-owned, like we're not comfortable with private?
I think you're playing with fire. You start doing something like that.
I don't know, but what if this does turn into them taking parcels by eminent domain, yeah, for this purpose?
Think about that. They wouldn't be doing it because of Plimpton. They'd be doing it because of large towns that didn't comply. Maybe Middleborough, because they got an awful lot of land.
Yeah, they do. But, and
they have the Middleborough-Lakeville line. It's right on the, yeah. I think it's actually in Lakeville, possibly, but it's like right near the line.
You're the committee.
Yeah,
you guys figure it out.
Yeah. You guys figure
it's
it out.
It's above that pay grade.
We'll report back.
Yeah. Come up with something really crappy. All right, so we have a motion, and I seconded it. So all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, so that's the MBTA. All right, so warrants paid, I think.
Warrants paid were $30,073.34, and the bulk of this was for Habib and Associates for their work on the old townhouse roof bidding.
Great. Thank you, Liz.
Did you ever check whether we really have to do this warrants paid each time?
So it was part of the, I can check currently. I know at one point it was part of the Municipal Modernization Act, and it's meant to save time so that you just get, like,
we used to go through the whole stupid thing, every warrant.
Sometimes we do $6,000.
Right.
You know, as if that was the month's expense.
Yeah.
You know, it's ridiculous.
I know, it is kind of crazy.
Anyways.
All right, Liz, do you have an update for us?
So just been busy with all the town meeting prep and the budgets and the warrants. We do have some correspondence items, though. We have a request for use of town property, and this is from the Plimpton Garden Club.
Oh, yeah.
And this is for the plants and a bake sale as well, on the town green on May 20th, 8 a.m. to 1 p.m.
And that's Election Day?
Yes.
Oh, Election Day, yes.
Yes. And the fire chief has already signed off on this. So if you want to vote it and just require that the other department heads.
Okay.
Assuming that they're all set.
I'll make a motion that we authorize the Garden Club to do their annual plant and bake sale on the election day at the on the town green. That's where they do this, is that right?
Yes.
Okay. From 8 to 1 on May 20th. Provided they get all the necessary signatures. All right. And second?
And this was the Garden Club?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. I'll second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Someone just wants to sign the bottom. Just one is fine. And then we have a vote required. This is for Old Colony Elder Services. And this is to continue Dottie Martell's nomination for the town of Plimpton. And this would be for July 1, 2023 to June 30th, 2024. Again, for Dottie Martell to continue serving as our nominee to Old Colony Elder Services.
She's done this, and she's willing to keep doing it, so.
Which is wonderful. All right, so I'll make a motion that we, is this nominating her?
Yes.
Nominating Dottie Martell to represent the town of Plimpton on Old Colony Planning Council Elder Services, effective July 1st, 2023 to June 30th, 2024.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
And that concludes correspondence.
All right. Nothing for the auditing contract?
Yes, I just wanted to make sure on that one, actually, that that was the one I sent you for Lynch and Marini. Yep. I wanted to make sure that you were comfortable with the 3 years. I'm comfortable with that. But I know we had been doing one-year contracts with
them. Says FY23. Aren't we in FY23?
We are, but they're always a year behind. So right now they're doing the FY22 audit.
Okay. Yeah, they wait for everything to close before they...
I'm comfortable with that because I feel like that would bring us to a good spot where we're already in 23 now. So next fiscal, they would start the 23 audit. I don't think it's unreasonable to keep them on board for those 3 years, especially where they helped us get things off the ground with our new financial staff. That said, I think after that point, it might be worth exploring options.
The Department of Revenue made a recommendation that we change auditors.
Right. And I'm sure it's good to switch it up sometimes to just a different set of eyes. If you're comfortable approving that, though, that would be great if we can solidify that.
All right, I'll make a motion that we award the contract for auditing services for Lynch and Marini for FY23 through FY25.
Second.
Roll call. I'm sorry, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, next item is the minutes. So we've got minutes from 3:27, 4:10, and 4:15.
Mm-hmm.
Did you both get a chance to read them?
Yeah, I didn't get the, to look at the, I guess they were fixed up a little.
Yeah, it was, there were a couple issues in the beginning.
I'm fine.
Okay, did you have any additional changes to any of those minutes?
I do not.
Okay, I'll make a motion. We accept the minutes from March 27th, April 10th, and April 15th as written.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay.
Liz, did you get a note from me about the guidance over here?
Yes, I will take care of that.
Okay.
All right, so our next meeting will be 5:08 and then followed by 5:22. So we'll finish things up with Graves.
Are we going to, we usually at least put up a notice just before town meeting in case something comes up last minute.
Is 5:22
May 17th is town meeting.
May 17th is town meeting.
Okay.
So do you want me to post a meeting for 6:30?
Yeah,
perfect. That sounds great, Liz.
Yeah.
Okay.
On the 17th.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll go first. My rave is Liz and the financial team and what a pleasure it was to go through the warrant this time. Oh my gosh. Like night and day to years past. Oh my gosh. Where you guys had really done your diligence on these articles and worked with the necessary parties to make sure you had all the information and so that good decisions could be made and that we could work through this seamlessly. So thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome.
It's a lot of work.
It is. It's a good process, though. Yeah. Town government at work.
It worked. Mm.
I would echo that and appreciate how the process is evolving and getting more and more polished each year. And that has a lot to do with Liz, and I appreciate that. My rave is a single word, spring.
Yay.
So my rave is for all the volunteers who turned out for cleanup day. Every road except 58 and 106 was lined up well. So if you go around...
It does look good.
It does.
They did a really nice job.
Yep. So.
And they had a nice day cleaning up.
It was. It was a perfect day for doing it. Yeah.
It wasn't too hot. So yeah, absolutely. Well done.
A lot of participants, a lot of shout outs to the people who are running it, the Albertis and the various people. They did a great job.
Yeah, and then Highway goes around and picks it all up too.
Yeah, though Dave was coming around with his truck.
Oh, was he? Picking it up too?
Yeah, so it was nice.
Anything else?
I'll save them for next time.
Okay, yeah, you usually don't have one. You usually have multiples.
I have multiples. Well, I do have this. We have an opportunity coming up with the Girl Scouts that the gardens are going to be recreated out here. And one of the leaders, I believe it's her brother, he's a vendor for this old house. And he brought them in, and they are going to, they've confirmed that they will landscape the gardens and build them. So you'll be hearing more about that. We're going to, May 6th, the Girl Scout leaders will be coming to the library to talk about it. So
very exciting.
Very exciting, yeah.
Very good.
And we'll be filmed and all that. So.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
That's very nice. All right, so that's all we've got for tonight. So I'll make a motion to adjourn. Do you have a second?
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Good night.